Something that becomes glaringly obvious to new options traders is that there's a lot of instruments to choose from. There's various strike prices, puts versus calls, different expirations. This is very different from trading underlying spot price. There's only one price and one instrument that you need to worry about when you're trading the underlying. When you're trading options, there's various contracts that all derive their value from that same underlying. So here's the big question. Which options are cheap and which ones are expensive? What's more expensive? A $50 call on a $1,000 underlying that's at the money that expires in 90 days? Or a $25 call on that same underlying with the same at the money strike price that expires in 10 days? What's more expensive, the $50 price tag or the $25 price tag? In dollar terms, the $25 price tag is cheaper. But in volatility terms, in this example, the 90-day $50 price tag option has a volatility of about 25, whereas the 10-day $25 option has a volatility of about 31. That's where implied volatility comes in. It helps you understand which options are expensive and which options are cheap, because implied volatility will normalize for all the various factors. Different strike prices, puts versus calls, different expirations, those are all normalized back down to one single number. And that single number is the implied volatility. This is why traders look at implied volatility. Now, there's another question whether 25 implied volatility or 31 implied volatility is rich or cheap compared to the underlying volatility itself, meaning the realized volatility itself, but that's gonna be for a different video. For now, just understand that implied volatility allows you to see the relatively expensive or cheap price that options are offering in a single number. The next question that comes to mind is, what does this implied volatility number mean? What does 31% implied volatility mean? Well, by convention, when people talk about implied volatility, what they're referring to is one standard deviation over a whole year of continuously compounding returns. Meaning, one standard deviation of 31% means that the asset, or the option is pricing that the underlying asset is gonna move 31% continuously compounded up or 31% continuously compounded down per year. That's what the option is implying that the volatility is. That's why we call it implied volatility. Now that we know what the implied volatility number means, the next question is, where does this number come from? There's a lot of different formulas that someone could apply to extract an implied volatility. The most common one is the Black-Scholes. We'll get into more discussions about the Black-Scholes formula in other videos. But for now, just assume that we're talking about the Black-Scholes formula. Well, within the Black-Scholes formula, there's a lot of factors that are known and only one factor that's unknown. The factors that are known is, where is the strike price of the option? When does the option expire? Where is the underlying right now? What is the risk-free interest rate? This is kind of an iffy one, but with low interest rates, we can almost be sure that it's a very little non-material impact. Does the asset have dividends or not? In the case of Black-Scholes, we assume there's no dividends. And lastly, what is the implied volatility? Well, of all those factors, implied volatility is the only one that is unknown. You see, the market determines the price of options. It's not the Black-Scholes formula that determines the price of options. It's the price of options that are determined by the market, and then the Black-Scholes formula is applied to that price, that dollar price, to spit back out an implied volatility. So what does that mean? That means that every day, supply and demand decides how expensive or cheap options are. And by applying the formula to the current market price of the options, we can sort of back out the implied volatility. And we translate that backed out implied volatility to that single number that we can compare to all the other options. We can compare to the realized volatility of the underlying asset. And that's how we understand whether options are rich or cheap against each other, or rich or cheap against the underlying, so on and so forth. So it isn't the Black-Scholes formula that's determining the price of the option. It's the price of the option that has the Black-Scholes formula applied to it to determine the implied volatility level. Now, some of you who have been trading highly volatile asset classes like cryptocurrencies may have seen options with implied volatilities greater than 100%. How is that possible? How is it possible that only one standard deviation can be greater than 100%? Well, the key assumption here is that the Black-Scholes implied volatility assumes continuously compounded returns. Which, what that means is that 100% return to the upside, continuously compounded, is really 271%, whereas 100% return to the downside, continuously compounded, is really a loss of about 69% in absolute terms. This continuously compounded assumption allows asset prices to be bound by zero and allows asset prices to be upper bound by infinity. This assumption is very important to the Black-Scholes formula, and this is why we can get implied volatilities that are greater than 100%. I hope you found this video useful, and until next time, find edge, capture alpha, and slang size.